what I think the world does today is to focus too much on form and not on functionality. And you, it's all right to be not so good looking, but if you're functioning really well, I think it's something that the body can teach us. Message for you architects, since I'm a client. It's too much emphasis on form. Too much emphasis on form. I have had my interior decorator saying that, look, I've created something of such beauty, don't spoil it by sitting on the sofa. and don't do that to your clients, because finally, what is it for? What is all this for? It is, the whole point is functionality. And functionality is just disappearing from the world of architecture, and that is what my big worry is. I know we need glass buildings so that we can look like Chicago, and we can, you know, we can do away with all these silly structures, like which look around, if you look around you. And there's too much of emphasis on looking good, looking, if you see, even in my profession, everybody wants to get their nose straightened, want to get their hair back, and I mean, it's all form everywhere. And what about functionality? It's all right to be dysfunctional as long as you're good looking. The thing that we didn't do well in our evolutionary process is to stand up. We were built to walk on fours. We were doing pretty well that way. And suddenly, through the evolutionary process, we decided to stand up. And a lot of my problems that I deal in my daily practice is because we decided, human beings decided to stand up. And what happens with standing up is that the body, which was designed to be on all fours, the spine, is not strong enough to take the weight of the head, because it was supported on four legs. And suddenly you have this very heavy structure, you have a thin neck, and you have a spine. Imagine you're riding a motorcycle, or you meet with a car accident, and suddenly your head, which is a big ball on top of your very fragile neck, it goes, and that's how you end up breaking your neck, you end up being a paraplegic. The problem of the spine, we haven't really sorted out. I think we'll have to go a couple of more generations before our spine slowly evolves into a standing spine. Right now, we are still in the evolutionary process between chimpanzees and really well-refined human beings. But the thing is that you are probably a little taller in the morning, and by the time you get through your day, your spinal processes, your spinal discs that are there in between, these are the shock absorbers between the vertebra, which keep getting compressed from time to time. And that, if you have a sudden impact, that jelly squirts out, compresses those multiple nerves that come out from the thing, and then you get what is called a slip disc. Good business for us, but basically a design problem. The best spine clinics all have very good architects, because they are the ones who are able to understand structure. And they're, in fact, I have even seen a building which has been built like this, like the spine. Exactly. So obviously, its spine has been a thing of fascination for everybody, and we need a lot of architectural help, because I think manufacturer had other plans for us, and then we suddenly are doing other things with the spine, and that is causing a lot of spinal problems. The other common thing that I deal with in my practice is varicose veins. You know, where you have varicose veins, where you have these veins swelling up in your legs, and your legs slowly start having a lot of black spots on it. Now, the problem of the varicose veins is that the way the body was designed, the veins were not designed to take so much of pressure. So the heart is up here, and the legs are down there. You need all that blood to come back to the heart, then go to the lungs, get purified, and come back to the legs. So especially when you're running, you need to do all that. Now, if you have your pump up here and your blood is out there, and it goes by a series of valves, so the blood keeps getting pushed up and the valve closes, and then you go further up and the valve closes. It's like having your pump on the 13th floor and expecting all the water to be pumped up from the ground floor all the way to the 13th floor. And that's where things have gone wrong, because the pressure, as you know, on the ground floor, when you open the tap, there's a lot of pressure, and that's the pressure that you have right at the lower at your ankles. Very quickly, those pipes burst, those valves burst, and those valves start swelling up, and that blood never comes up for purification. So the blood stays there, slowly stagnates, and all that poison which collects in that blood starts to seep out into the skin, and your legs slowly, slowly turn black. Again, there are no valves that we have to replace. Because if we had valves that we could put back, which were damaged, then we would have some kind of a sensible solution. Now we have to make them wear stockings. And if you see, a lot of policemen go around wearing stockings because that helps pump the blood back to the heart. Or you have to do shirsasana every day so that some blood comes, gets purified and goes. This is not a very practical solution. So these are design issues which came up, which is a plumbing issue, but we have no clear-cut easy solutions for that. It's waiting for an architect to find how you're going to be able to get blood from the ground floor to the 13th floor, and we don't have any good solutions for that. The other problems of evolution has been this whole giving up squatting. I think it's all come from the Western world. A lot of this civilized things, people decided that it's the chair that we need to sit on, and the whole chair culture has come in a very big way. And we would traditionally squat a lot. And what would happen with squatting is that when the femoral head would rotate, it would get well lubricated all around. And all parts of that femoral head would actually get utilized. Now, when we sit, it's only this movement, and the rest of the movement is not well utilized. And you start having a lot of wear and tear on one part, and the other parts are not well lubricated. The other advantage of the Indian process of squatting, especially to pass motions, was that the hernial orifices, where you have this common problem of hernia, which way you have this thing bursting through your groin area, that automatically gets covered when and closed by your thigh when you are putting pressure, when you have to pass motions. Again, a very nice Indian way to prevent these kind of problems. But then we all decided to sit on the chair and pass motions like the king and the queen. And that's when all the problems started.